This right here is the fifth metatarsal. So you can see this is the head and this is the styloid process. We're talking fifth metatarsal fractures, including the Jones fracture right here and an avulsion fracture, which is a fracture of this piece right here. So the fifth metatarsal can happen with ankle sprains, outside of the foot pain. If it's getting worse and crippling, aching pain and redness, we're going to solve your fifth metatarsal pain right now.
So what does the bruising look like? You're really going to see bruising kind of like this. There's going to be some blood over a day or two. You usually sprain your ankle. You feel a pop or a crack. And then the bruising, it's not that you damage your toes, but the blood actually leaks down with gravity. You'll probably see some bruising along the bottom as well. In another picture, that's what it looks like around the side, middle, outside of the foot. It's really going to hurt when you press on it with your finger. That's how you know you have a Jones fracture. I always love to take a look at x-rays. So this right here is a Jones fracture. That's a clear one. But take a look at this one up here. When it's more in the middle or the front of the foot, that's more of a stress fracture throughout the middle of the foot. That doesn't always need surgery. That's the good news. The stress fracture is more in the middle, whereas the Jones fracture is more in the blue zone here. The blue zone will be a longer recovery time and may necessitate surgery in some cases.
You could have a few different fractures. So you could have a fracture there. You could have a fracture right here. You could have a fracture through here like this, or you can have a fracture through here. So you can see one, this is called an avulsion fracture. This is called a Jones fracture. This is an oblique midshaft fracture. And then you could have a head fracture. The head, I don't really see these too common, although it is possible for sure. Because this bone has so much motion compared to, say, these middle ones. See how these middle ones can't really move? The middle ones are more likely to break in the front, whereas the fifth metatarsal can break at any of these areas. If you want to know more about the other four metatarsals, so 1, 2, 3, and 4, we're going to link a video right here, how to self-diagnose and feel those fractures and what to do about them. But today it's the fifth metatarsal. So this is the fifth metatarsal right here. So you can see that this is a normal bone right here to right here. A lot of times people feel this part of the bone and think that's an abnormal bone. Again, if that's hurting, that means your foot's twisting up too much. And watch the end of the video to see why this is necessarily a problem. Right here is the Taylor's bunion. If you're aching along the shaft of the bone, there's a lot of things that could be broken. Right here is what's called the Jones fracture. In the middle, you can have a stress fracture. And right up here, you can have a neck fracture. So you can get a stress fracture in the middle. This is a repetitive overuse fracture injury. And what happens is this can sometimes not be apparent on x-rays, but it starts to ache. And what happens is right here in this area, there's an area called your Jones fracture region. This part of the bone has less blood flow, so it's notorious for taking its time to heal. I mean, months have sometimes gone by in some of my patients and it has not gotten better. This can lead to redness, aching, inability to put weight on the side of your foot, constant pain that's getting worse and not getting better during the day. You could also have a fracture of the outside right here. This is called an avulsion fracture. And the reason this is difficult is because you have your peroneal tendon right here that inserts into your fifth metatarsal. If you have peroneal problems, we're going to link a video up here to the tendons along the outside of your foot right here. But a chunk of your bone where that tendon inserts can rip out. And this is a very hard bone to heal as well. If the base of this bone hurts right here, you can see I drew a green tendon right here coming along the back of my leg. This is called your peroneus brevis. We have a guide for your peroneal tendons, but as that tendon inserts there, as your ankle sprains, you could see if here's the tendon and I yank in real quick, it's going to rip that chunk of the bone back and out. So that could lead to that bone breaking or that tendon partially ripping out of the bone, causing problems. That needs some time to heal. The avulsion fracture, same thing, outside of the foot pain, redness, swelling, aching. So how do you diagnose fifth metatarsal, Jones fractures, and avulsion fractures? You have to see your podiatrist. So number one, we're going to evaluate and feel the side of your foot, what you already know is broken. You also need an x-ray. This is where it makes sense. If there is a break, there's no buts about it. You basically have to be in a cast or a boot and keep pressure off of it at the bare minimum, even if you avoid surgery. So we usually get people a letter to be off work or minimized work, any type of disability you need, because it's realistically going to take months and months. We're talking like 3 months potentially. So you need to be in a boot or a cast. We usually get you a scooter as well. I'm a huge fan of the scooter. Whatever other assistive devices you may need at home, like crutches. I'm not a huge fan of crutches. Personally, I hate crutches. I say that very strongly. It hurts people's armpits. Nobody uses them properly. As a result, they fall over and injure themselves. So a knee scooter or even an iWalk 2.0 can be good, but be careful with these things. I have had people fall. A boot is sometimes better than a cast, but the problem is people take off their boots at home and at night and they can resprain and injure them. If it's a terrible fracture, sometimes you want the cast because you feel a million times better in a compressive dressing called an Una boot with a cast over it. People's pain dramatically drops. Even though it seems like a boot feels more comfortable, trust me, the cast with a compressive dressing, people feel a lot better. And at the same time, even though anti-inflammatories can theoretically slow bone healing, you might want that pain relief for a day or two, even some pain medication if you can't fall asleep the first night. So you've got a cast or a boot, you're keeping pressure off of it, you want to know whether you need surgery. The Jones fracture, realistically, especially in athletes, can get better with percutaneous surgery. So what percutaneous surgery is making a small little poke in the side of the skin right here and throwing a screw through the bone. Realistically, you only need like 2 stitches and that heals pretty quickly. That keeps the bone in place. That lets people start putting some weight on it in a walking boot. Whereas if you don't throw that screw, if you choose not to do that surgery and you don't need to, a cast works great and a boot works great. If it's really dislocated. So sometimes I've had diabetic patients or people with poor feeling in their foot that have broken the bone and the bone has shifted. And I mean, months have gone by. Sometimes you need a plate. And it's called the hook plate that I use. It grabs the edge of the bone and squeezes it together. And it has a plate on the side of the foot right through here. And that holds that bone together. So a hook plate can work really well in a lot of cases. That's the heavy duty stuff. I would say rarely, except for diabetics and something called sarcoarthropathy, where they can't feel their foot.
So a screw can work really well. It's a little bit easier and less of an incision to put in, but the plate can also work well. It's a little bit more heavy duty, but a little bit of bigger incision. They both work excellent.
How long does it take to heal a Jones fracture or an avulsion fracture? If you're able to offload it or do surgery properly, I would say on average, people feel about 50% better in 6 weeks, about 75% better at 3 months, and about 95% better at 6 months, then about 100% better at 1 year. So it takes a long time. Everybody's always a little bit different. So the younger and healthier people heal a little bit quicker. But don't think that this is going to take you 2 weeks. Even people who are 18-year-olds that don't weigh a lot, it's still going to take them a few months. You still need to be in the scooter. You still have to protect yourself. People who are older, so like 60s, 70s, 80s, realistically, you're going to need a lot of physical therapy. You're going to need some help around the house. You might need home care because you're going to develop hip problems. You're going to develop back problems compensating for that injured leg. So that's how we take care of fifth metatarsal fracture.